Hi everyone, this is Sharon. I am back today with my September design team project for Luise Heinzl. What I used for the basis of this project is her Marry Me Juliet kits. And there are two of them. There's one that has journal pages and another that has ephemera. And I'm a pretty literal person, so when I saw Marry Me Juliet as the title, I immediately thought, wedding keepsake journal. And that's one I've been wanting to make for quite some time, so I went with that. This project really took on a life of its own once I got started with it. My thought was to make a journal with three sections. One could be used as a wedding guest book. The second could be used for planning and writing notes and memories from the day. And the third section could be used to put in all those snippets and keepsakes that you would have from the wedding, like flowers and place cards and napkins and tickets and receipts and all those kinds of things. So I proceeded to make my three signatures, and then they grew and grew and grew and outgrew the book cover that I selected. So there was no way I was going to get my three signatures into this one book cover. So it ended up being a two book set. And what I did was I took the first signature that I was going to use as a guest book and made that into a separate one, and then took the other two signatures and split them up into three signatures and put those in the main book. Now, I'm calling this a wedding guest book, keepsake book, but there's not a lot in here that really screams wedding. It's just a very soft, romantic type of journal, and so it could certainly be used as a writing journal or keepsake for other things as well. So just keep that in mind as I go through. I'm going to warn you, this is probably going to be a long video, much longer than my normal, because there's a lot in here. So I'll get started. I wrap the books in this soft chiffon-like ribbon, and I think what I'll do is take you through this first, this smaller journal. So what I did here is I did use an old book cover and recovered it. I used a raw silk material for the spine, and then I also covered it with a lace paper. And I think it's fitting for me to use this silk because I actually bought this fabric intending to make a wedding or a dress for myself for my daughter's wedding a number of years ago, and I never did. So guess what? It's going to start making its way into some of my journals. I really love that fabric. So what I did in here is, like I said, it could be set up as either a writing journal or a guest book because there are a lot of lined pages in it. On the inside cover, there's a little pocket there, and I tucked in this image of a wedding, and then on the back there's an image of an old marriage certificate, which is really beautiful. This is some coffee dyed paper that I made recently, and the ephemera kits that Luise has with this, there's a fussy cut page of flowers and another fussy cut page with all dragonflies and butterflies, and they're really quite beautiful. On this page, I took an antique lace collar, a piece of that, and that's on the bottom. And then I layered it with some velvet ribbon, sari trim, and this heart charm. So this is one of the journal pages. Many of the journal pages in this kit are of beautiful, ethereal women. And you'll find when you go out to Luise's Etsy shop and look at the kit, it's very vibrant. It's got some beautiful bright colors like oranges and pinks and purples and darker greens mixed with golds and all different, you know, really nice vibrant colors. But when I decided I was going to make more of a romantic wedding type journal, I just knew that those vibrant colors wouldn't work for me in this particular journal. And Luise knows that I'm a vintage person and I like more subdued colors. So I took the saturation down on the kit and made it more of a sepia tone, and I think that just fit better with what I was working with here. So I added a little bit of bling onto this page, and then I incorporated some line papers. Also with her beautiful kit, I incorporated some gentleman pictures in finely dressed attire. I just thought that went well with the women. So I'm going to add some labels that will say guest list, and they can be used and incorporated if it is used as a guest book or not. Also, as part of her kit, she's got some beautiful marble papers, and I use those in here as kind of a mat for some of the photos that I put in. So these are photos that I took of my yard, some flowers you'll see throughout here, and I put them, mounted them with these photo corners so they can be removed and personal pictures could be put in there. So on the pictures, I've added some lace. Here's another page from the kit. This is a doily, another of my coffee dyed papers. This is from a botanical book, and I added punch trim there and also on this side. On this page, I added a leather button and another vintage button. So this is the title page of the keepsake book, and it's actually a very old book from 1880. And near as I can tell, it's a Swedish, it's got some beautiful writing, but I can't read it. I believe it's, from what I could interpret, it's a book of sermons from an 18th century preacher. And his name was Lars Linderots. And this is a page from the book. It's got really beautiful script. And this is a piece of vellum where I printed a wallpaper image, and then I attached a pretty blingy button to the strings. Another page from the book. On this page, I took some men's shirting and layered it with a snippet from a men's silk tie and a pretty button. This is another botanical page, another journal page from the kit. And on this photo, again from my yard, I just added some lace to the bottom. On this page, I made a belly band from a piece of velvet ribbon. And I clipped in this envelope with a vintage clip earring, and that works really nice as kind of a paper clip. And I embossed this vellum or glassine envelope. And then I added a little bit of trim. So here's a dragonfly that I cut out, fussy cut from her ephemera kit, and then I just layered it with some lace and sari trim, and I just thought those colors went really well with this button. Then inside, I inserted a copy of an old love letter. It's a really sweet letter. I thought that would go well in here. On the back cover, I have this printout of a family tree page. And then I just backed it with this heart garland wreath. So that's this book. As you can see, like I said, it could be used as a guest book or a journal. And then the main journal that I would call more of a keepsake journal, I would envision this could easily be used as a place to plan out a wedding. There are lots of places to make lists and write. And then also I put lots of pockets and envelopes and places in here to tuck things, like I said, memorabilia from the wedding or any other event that you would want to use it for. So a little bit about the book. I am a person who has no problem at all gutting old books. I just don't mind doing it. I like to give them new life, and I really like to see how the old books are bound, and I love to get in there and see what the binding looks like on the inside. I just find that really fascinating. Where I really have a problem is if it's an old cover that I love, especially a beautiful spine like this one. It's just got a wonderful age patina. I just can't bring myself to put anything on it. I tried lace, I tried papers, and in the end, I just left it as is in its beautiful simplicity and could only bring myself to wrap it in a bowl. So that's what it is. So here's another page from the kit. Beautiful lady. And then this gentleman page, I added a piece of trim here with some small silver beads and a bold button. There are some fun pages in here too with little mirrors and ovals where it'd be fun to make lists, maybe write your attendance or something like that, or do some planning on there. This is a page from the book. Here I created an envelope and added some of those dragonflies from the kit. And then inside, I made a journaling card, and this is a piece of antique French ephemera from 1889. So that might be a fun place to write as well. Oops, sorry. Here again, I added to this marble paper as mounting another flower photo. Beautiful lady from the kit. Here I created a pocket. This is one of the fussy cut flowers from the kit that I added there. And then I just made a couple of journaling cards. This is a actual French postcard from my collection. It's from 1906. What I really like about this, it's very romantic, but also they added the stamp and kind of wrapped it around the corner. I thought that was really unique and different. And then it's wrapped around on this side. And it is dated 1906, and this is the original. I just added a little bit of velvet ribbon to the top of that pin. And then on this side, I clipped this little tag. This is a strip of butterflies from one of the fussy cut pages, and I just left those all together and added a velvet ribbon to the bottom and then backed it. There are some lady circles in the kit as well. And then this is just a journaling card I made. This is one of the fussy cut flowers from the kit. Here I added some inking to this doily to kind of bring out the colors in this page here. This is some vintage fabric that I backed and stitched onto this. I thought that was a romantic image of a man and a lady planting flowers. Except for I don't think today you'd see a man planting flowers in a suit and tie. Here I took an old envelope and wrapped it around the page and stitched it on, and it creates kind of a belly, a double tuck inside the envelope and behind. So I inserted this tag, and then on this page I have another tag, and these are flowers from the kit. I've got a tuck at the top, and I created this journaling card. And this is an image, I believe it's from Sheet Music. It is a digital kit that I pulled from somewhere. And these ladies just reminded me of maybe wedding attendants or something. And there's lots of place to plan or journal on the back. This is another journaling card that I made. Did a little stenciling on the back. with some paste and added a little dragonfly. That's a really sweet image too. Here I created just a little envelope of sorts, and I added this as a piece of vintage jewelry. And inside here, this is a music sheet. I thought it would be fun to maybe plan out your wedding music in here. These are flowers from the kit. And then there are pockets throughout. And this is a journaling spot I created from a vintage piece of wallpaper. And on there, I attached a piece of music. This is sheet music from the 1920s. It was Beethoven. Just added a little trim on there and can do some planning and journaling inside there. And I added another one of the fussy cut flowers onto this page. On this photo, I stitched on a little bit of trim and I just left all these threads on there. This is more of my coffee dyed paper. On this page, I clipped some things that could be used for menu planning. I envision these as maybe place cards. And then this is a 1985 menu from a wedding. I just added a stamp, and back here you could do some wedding menu planning. On this page, I have a little pocket here I stitched on, and then some copies of calling cards. And I just did some very faint stenciling on the back of that one. Here again, another fun place to journal or make a list. Beautiful lady from the kit. Here I used some vintage French fabric that I bought from someone over in France, and I put a little ruffled edge on there, kind of a chiffon-like material. And inside there, I put a piece of vintage French ledger paper. And then I blinged up this lady from the kit again. This is another, she's got some pages in the kit with water and butterflies, and oh, they're just beautiful. They're very calming. I paired that with a lace image. And then this journal card is a copy of a postcard that I have in my collection, and I thought that went with the wedding theme. And then I just put some pretty paper on the back. But I thought this would be an example of a nice way to preserve flowers. If you didn't want to save your entire bouquet, you could snip and press some flowers from bouquets or centerpieces, and then, you know, make little kind of faux specimen cards out of them. These I just put some washi tape around the outside. And then I put them on here with a little brad that has W for wedding. On this page, I created a belly band and added a little bit of lace onto that. And then this week while I was in the thrift store, I found this box of copper paper clips, and I was so excited. And here I took a page from the book and I just made it into a journaling spot. In that same thrift store trip, I also found a pad of really old yellowed tracing paper, so I was really excited about that too. And you can write in this, I tried it, and so it'd be a fun place to write things with the script in the background. On this side I have a little side tuck, and in there I have this journaling card where I used an image of an old postcard. And I created a pocket on there and just added a little card in there. On this side, I created an envelope out of craft paper, and it's got this nice filigree on here, and I did some fancy stitching. Then it does have a metal or a magnetic closure, so it does stay closed. And then I put this image from the ephemera kit in here, so it's a nice place to tuck things. On this page, I have to tell you about this paper at the top. I have this old trunk. It's probably 17, 1800s. And I just noticed the other day what beautiful paper it has on the inside, but it's really peeling off. So I've started peeling off that grungy old paper and I'm going to use it in my journals. I just love it. And then I just topped that with one of the flowers from the kit. On this side, I created a belly band from a piece of sari trim. And in there, I tucked this image from a beautiful old church. And that can be used as a journal card. And then I also included this wedding invitation from the mid-1900s. It has beautiful script. You could use the back to journal on. On this side, I did some cascading pockets here, and what I used for the front of those are just images from the journal pages in the kit. I added some lace trim on there, and then made a few journaling cards to put in. Here's more of that beautiful marble paper, and I attached some windowed envelopes. And in there, I just placed some altered playing cards. Really like that. So I have a queen on this side and a king on that side. And I believe I left these open on the side. Yes, so you could tuck something in there as well. And then I just backed this with a lace paper. And then I'll just show you the king card quickly. I also did stenciling with some paste on there and gessoed them up a little bit. And then in the center here, I've got this beautiful calligraphy. That's from one of tailor-made journal kits. And then on the strings, I just added a couple of dainty little hearts. Here I did a little cluster with some lace paper, a piece of velvet ribbon, and a butterfly from the kit. And then over here, I've got the cascading pockets again. I just added a little bit of sari trim on there, and I gave these a cummerbund element at the bottom. I thought that was fitting for a wedding theme. And then these are some journaling cards that I made to go in. And again, these would be great spots to tuck those tickets and tags and receipts that you might have. Again, I used some vintage leather button, and this is a dark green button. Here's another craft pocket envelope that I made, and in there I tucked what could be used as a journaling sheet. This is the very first page of this book, and I always like to preserve these if there's writing on it, since it was probably the original owner, and it says, "Present to Adeline Nelson from Grandma Margaret Transon." And I just did stenciling on there and then left the back for journaling. And here's another journal card from an old French postcard. And on this side, I added another wedding invitation image from the 1800s. I just love how simple they were back then. They used beautiful handwriting, beautiful script, but kept them very simple. Another beautiful page from the kit. Lady. And then here's the other side of that vintage French fabric, and I just added a washi stamp and tucked in. This is some original French ephemera also, and this is a check from 1928. On this page with these gentlemen, I took a tag and I wrapped it around the page so it creates a side tuck. And then this is another dragonfly from the kit. Here I created an expandable envelope, and it's made from vellum. I've got this ribbon that comes through the back. I made a flap that's attached to the page. And then I added a gusset made from cheesecloth just to give it, you know, some expandability if you want to put a bunch of things in there. Every time I land on this page, I just go, ah. I find it very tranquil and calming. Here I added a piece of vintage linen, and on there I again used some of that old French fabric, some lace, and I thought this would be a really fun place to clip on maybe fabrics from a wedding or an event. So I just, as a sample, added some netting and lace and some taffeta silk and chiffon, things that you might find in wedding attire. And I did just some very rudimentary stitching on here. I've been inspired a lot lately by everyone who's doing the slow stitching. I used to do a lot of embroidery and cross stitch. I haven't for years, so I stuck to very fundamental type things and try my hand at French knots. I don't even know if I did them right, but they kind of gave me the effect I wanted there. So I think those are pretty. And then I added a very faint blue button on there. And then the other side of this, I'm really excited about this page too, because I remember seeing, I think it was Martha Stewart who had a little tutorial on how to emboss velvet. So I took a piece of velvet trim, and I don't know if you can see this or not, but you can use your rubber stamps and actually put your velvet onto the rubber stamp top side down and then iron over the top of it for 10 to 20 seconds and you get this embossing effect. And I like how it's not real even either. Some places it didn't take, so it almost looks like you pulled it off a piece of old upholstery or something. Love that effect. So I added some lace on there and another bluish button. This is also my coffee dyed paper as well. And then in the center of the signature, I created a couple of pockets. These are nice deep pockets. And again, I gusseted them with some cheesecloth so they're expandable. And this is actually one of the fussy cut pages. And I just left the whole thing as is, but you can cut out all these individual flowers. I just like the way it all looked together. So I used, this is a little bit more color saturation, and then this is a little bit more sepia on this side. And then here's the other side of that fabric linen and the stitching. On this page, I created kind of a tufted bulletin board effect with velvet ribbon and then some flowers from the kit. I just pinned on some buttons, but it would be a great place again to pin on some charms or, you know, buttons, little pieces of memorabilia. And then this again is one of Luise's beautiful images. This is another pocket like the previous one that is also gusseted. And believe it or not, that takes us to the back cover. So that is my project for September, guys. I really had a lot of fun making that, as usual, I always do. So it was, I think I would like to do more romantic themed soft journals. I really enjoy doing that. Not sure what I'll do for October, but until next time, bye-bye.